Hello, I'm Paul Dajicek, founder of Elastic Steel, method of athletic conditioning. Today we're going to talk about split and the foot positions and how that affects the split. No, I didn't switch from martial arts to dancing or gymnastics. Okay, I'm still doing martial arts. Yes, my toes are pointed. And I get this question very often. There's three major positions. One is toes pointed, one is toes pulled back, and one edges of the foot out to the side. Okay, so we have three of those positions, and for a long time people ask what is the difference in those positions. Well, most martial artists prefer this position, toes pulled back. I guess the idea comes from the fact that you would strike with a heel, or you would strike with the balls of the feet, although we do strike with an instep, right? But usually martial artists do their splits this way. Okay, so what will happen if you try to either bring your edges out to the side, or you try to point the toes? What will happen? Is there any difference, or is it just like moving the feet around? Well, believe it or not, there is a difference. I'm going to talk to you about that now. So if you have watched my previous videos, you know that if we bring the edges forward, this allows us to bring the foot from the vertical. I'm talking about, let's say, my right foot right now. From the vertical, as I do this, not only turns, it also comes forward, okay, like so. You could see the difference. Now, what does that do? If I was to keep this position, bring it up, and now put it flat, now I have my toes going back and my knees are not straight up, they're slightly back. This makes a difference. The reason this makes a difference is because my heels are now slightly more forward than my toes, okay? So my heels are a little bit more forward than my toes are. My toes are behind my heels. My toes are not over my heels. That makes a difference. What that really does, it forces you to slightly oversplit, believe it or not. Okay? So I'm gonna lean forward now and demonstrate the same thing. Okay? Now, if you were to place your heel while doing a split, let's say on a little yoga block or on a book, in order to oversplit, there will be a space, right? Right now there's no space. But if you were to lean forward and place it on something, there will be space. Guess what? Now there's space. No space, space. You could see that space right here. Okay, you could see it here. Now there's no space. So what does that do? That space forces you to oversplit. The same thing happens when you point the toes. There's no space here, but as you point the toes, there's space. That space forces you to oversplit. More for the hamstrings while sitting down this way, but as you lean forward a little bit, this becomes more for your adductors. Okay? So in short, pointing the toes or bringing the edge forward as much as possible forces you to slightly oversplit if you're going to keep your adductors on the floor. What you might notice is that you might have a good split here if you never did this before. Boom. And now you rose off the floor a little bit and now you have to press down. Okay? So that is the difference. Point your toes, edges out to the side, feet flat. Thank you for watching.